snappy new intro we have.
Very nice. Aloha. Welcome to another Live at 5 on 55. I'm Jason and this is Dana.
I'm Dana.
And we're here at Akaku, Maui Community Television Studios.
Yes.
And we are doing a live show Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday at 5 o'clock. And anything that's going on in the community, we want to know from you. And you can become part of what we do.
Stuff.
No, she has, if you send things to Dana at akaku.org,
D-A-N-A.
You can submit, I think it's the Akaku, A-K-A-K-U, Akaku.
Dot org.
If you send that stuff, we can get clips.
Take a video, take a photo, give me an event going on. If you want to get something out there, let me know.
Yeah.
Email me, submit it, turn
She's
it in.
She's crackerjack at editing.
I try to.
Yeah, I know. We have a regular thing from Jack Gist, who's going to tell us what's going on. Let's take a little news break, and we'll be right back.
Jack, and remind ourselves what we do here.
Aloha, and welcome to the Akaku Entertainment Report.
Oh, no, that wasn't Jack Gist.
It's that odd time in life, the slow weekend after the New Year's holiday, but the world of entertainment continues on, even if at a bit slower pace. On Wednesday, January 8th, we highlight two music shows. The first is a free concert from 5 to 8 p.m. at the Shops at Wailea, featuring jazz stylings by the husband and wife duo Phil and Angela Bonet. Featured in many shows around Maui, these two performers are always a hit with their audience. The second, a little bit different, is at Stella Blues Cafe in Kihei, where the Colorado Contemporary Bluegrass Band Leftover Salmon plays at 10 p.m. And finally, here's one activity that might make your must-see list. It's the premiere screening of the documentary Invasion, The Little Fire Ants in Hawaii, presented by the Maui Invasive Species Committee at the Max McCoy Theater at 5:30 p.m. With fire ants recently discovered on Maui, this could be a video not to miss. And on that note, I'm Tom Blackburn Rodriguez. Until next week with the Akaku Entertainment Report, right here on Channel 55.
Aloha, I'm Jack Gist with your Island News headlines. Hawaiian Airlines announced plans to add daily nonstop service between Los Angeles and Maui this summer. The service is expected to add more than 120,000 air seats to both travel markets when it launches July 1st. Airline officials say the addition of the year-round service is in response to increasing demand from the Southern California market. Firefighters returned to a Kailana Street home on Pakakalo yesterday after receiving reports of flames coming from the two-story structure. The same residence caught on fire Friday, displacing six residents from the home. The fire was reported at around 1:45 p.m. and both are under investigation. Zach Johnson won the Hyundai Tournament of Champions Monday afternoon on the plantation course of Kapalua. Johnson chipped in for his opening birdie and then hit four exquisite wedge shots on the back nine Monday to rally from two shots behind, close with a 7-under 66, and win the Tournament of Champions. With your Island News headlines, I'm Jack Gibbs.
And welcome back.
As you can see, Tom Blackburn Rodriguez did the entertainment report, which is telling us there's some stuff going on. There's all kinds of stuff
going on. Tomorrow, the Maui Invasive Species Committee, make sure I got it right, is actually premiering their brand new documentary about the fire ants.
Oh,
it's
yeah.
It's a 30-minute free documentary at the MAC tomorrow.
At what time?
I think it's 8 p.m.
Oh, okay.
You can correct me if I'm wrong. I believe it's 8 p.m. And then there's just two different concerts going on. One's wonderful.
Willie Kay, this is in the blues this weekend.
Yes,
and
this weekend.
And Marshall Tucker Band.
The bluegrass music is coming to Stella Blues tomorrow.
Oh, it's tomorrow.
I like bluegrass music.
Oh, wait, there's Leftover Salmon.
Leftover Salmon.
What kind of name is Leftover Salmon?
I think they smile when you say it, though.
Okay, I guess so.
Right, and it's bluegrass. You never really get. But,
and we've had things that, I mean, there's lots of stuff coming up. We just covered Jay April, our CEO here, went out to Lawmakers Listen. Roz Baker and Angus McKelvey did a thing on the West Side, and we're going to show a little clip on that.
The clip that I cut from it is basically talking about the underwater cable that they want to put in between Oahu and Maui.
Oh, good.
And so I cut it down to some banter, which should be pretty interesting. That seems to be a hot issue, and this answers some questions, at least for me. So,
let's take a look.
What are the goals for the? What are your legislative goals this year? Angus, you first. Okay, ladies first.
Ladies first.
Actually, I think Angus and I have very similar goals. We want to make sure that our schools are taken care of, the roadways are taken care of, the environment is not damaged with some of the repairs that need to be done, and we can take care of some of the beach renourishment needs to help with the visitor industry here. So
that's pretty much in a nutshell. Another thing too is to do things to hopefully, you know, help people out, you know, given the economy. We are looking at some measures for conformity and tax relief that will put a few dollars in everybody's pocket, which coupled with the other things we're doing, hopefully will keep things improving. So everybody's working and we have a great place to live, and, you know, Maui can stay no coin.
I'm a little bit limited to what I can say because I'll be one of the three decision makers. But I will tell you that there's a number of studies that have been offered in that docket that suggested, just as Roz said, that it could be more economical for the electric ratepayers on Maui if the cable existed, because there is potentially lower cost power on Maui, on Oahu, that could be transmitted over here. There's excess renewable energy here that's being wasted now that could be sent to Oahu, and to the point where that the benefits would potentially outweigh the cost of the cable.
So to answer your question directly,
yes.
Okay, I voted for the bill after we got a number of concessions and guarantees inside it that A, wasn't going to go to Lanai, wasn't going to go to Molokai, and had to have all of this properly vetted, because I think we would be remiss if we didn't explore it. I voted for that bill.
And Angus?
Yeah. Because here's the thing, though. I mean, by going to the PUC and by having the public look at it, we look at all the pros and cons. And if there is going to be major ramifications, then yeah, it stops. Bingo. By putting it to the PUC, we've added extra steps to public review. But if it could be done safely, I mean, look at the internet. Our internet now and everything we have is connected to the cables. If you just said no, just because we're just not even going to talk about it, we would have no internet on Maui. But if it could be done safely, cost-effective way that we, when we come and open up our electrical bills every month and actually see them reduced majorly, then we at least have to have an exploration of it. The public process, the PC process, helps everybody put in all the information, the community to decide and actually put the brakes and have a long thought-out process. With the original bill, which to your point was going to fast-track it along real fast, and we'll look at the land right away. So what we did was we've been stepping this thing way back. Is an interest between Maui Island and Oahu Island to not create the damage to our environment that can be used existing corridors, the EMF concerns about with anything, cultural concerns or anything like that, then it's worth us, especially if we can bring prices down and bring more renewables online, which means less houses and condos and shopping malls being built in more areas that perhaps have.
Well, I just want to make the statement that I feel that we are not the feeder island. We are the neighbor island, and it is not our mission, and it's not our mana'o, as you say, to make life easy for people on Oahu. Because we have open space and we have wind, well, so does Oahu. They've got lots of wind. So I am very anxious to see what you actually come up with, because in the newspaper, the benefits are minuscule, and what Maui is expected to pony up is huge.
You want to talk, just share what you think would be a reasonable time frame in terms of how things might be going along?
First of all, there's an EIS that has to be done. But if you look at what has been filed in the docket by several companies that want to build a cable, I mean, the earliest that they would even contemplate actually having something in would be 2020 or thereabouts. But before that would happen, it'd be all the environment, you know, all the permitting effort, all the environmental efforts. But the thing that I think, Raj, you said, or Angus, you said, the world could change. I mean, the cost of PV is dropping. There are other technologies that are emerging. And so one of the things that really makes this a tough decision is, you know, you're trying to make good decisions today versus, you know, for something that may not materialize until 2020.
Wow. That was pretty powerful.
Yeah.
And I think we have Dan Emhoff on the line.
Oh, good. We have Dan who's over in Molokai. How are you, Dan?
Good. How's everybody over there?
Great.
We're good. What's going on?
Well, let's see. The best news over here is that Akaku Molokai Media Center has a new part-time employee to help me out over here. Her name is Ruhi. Yeah.
We met her.
Yeah, I know. I heard she was on the show. That's like probably the most exciting thing happening over here. So that, you know, Akaku can expand what we do and how we service the community on Molokai.
I feel bad. I threw her in the fire. She came over for the first time and I have her co-host the show right off the bat.
You know what? I gave her a warning. I kind of figured that that would happen. So I was like, guess what? Don't be surprised if they put you on live TV right away.
Well, I asked her and she was game. And I thought, well, how often do we get someone from Molokai or Lanai? You know, I just threw her in. I was like, it'll be great. And she carried it off well. I think she hosted with you, right?
Yeah, she was hosting with me. Yeah. She was great. She was terrific.
Oh, awesome. Awesome.
And
yeah.
She carried it well.
Yeah, she's going to be a good asset. She's a hard worker. She's already looking at ways to make everything work better over here. So,
that's
exactly what we need. So.
And is she getting good at Final Cut Pro 10?
Yeah, she's actually working on, a family made an emu pit, and she documented the whole thing. She's putting it together. It's going to be a beautiful story, I'm sure.
Awesome, because only one of you can't do the whole Molokai Saturdays. We definitely need two of you over there.
There you go. That's right. Let's see. The other good news that I want to tell, if anybody from Molokai is actually watching this, which I'm sure they are, tomorrow night at Mitchell Pa'ole, there's going to be a wonderful presentation. I know that it was already aired live over there with Linda on her documentary about hemp.
Yes.
and how it is a wonderful building material and hempcrete. And I just want everybody to go because it's something that I believe is actually really important and a good thing for the islands.
Yeah, we cut a short clip and we showed it last night. Let's see if we can get it tonight too. But on Maui, at least, they were talking about how it could possibly replace sugarcane crops.
Well, I mean, it is a people's economy. Anybody can actually grow it in their backyard and then, turn it into a product.
Well, many products. That's the thing about it. It's so many products.
Right. Right. We need to get our heads wrapped around how good this thing could be.
Yeah.
So I'm definitely in support of it. So I just want to spread that good word.
All right, well, Dan, I think we lost you up on the screen, but we have you here. You're frozen right now.
Well, I'm really glad that that we're using Skype and all the technologies. Any of you are out there?
We got him back. There he is.
Yeah, I saw you guys the whole time.
Okay, good.
We appreciate
it. Hopefully we get a good connection.
Is that the biggest event coming up? Is there any more?
Yeah, that one is going to be big, and it's going to be cool. Linda is going to come into the office tomorrow at 1, and I'm going to do a talk story with her and record that and get that on Akaku as well.
Good.
And we'll go from there.
Because the one she did here on Maui with Lou, I cut the highlight reel I can give to you if you need a little preview, but we can talk about that later.
I would love to see it, and I'm totally looking forward to seeing the documentary on Akaku.
I know, we're so excited. We're running the promos
now. Yeah, good job, Akaku. Yeah. Good job, and let's just continue empowering our community's voice through access to media.
Say hi to Ruhi for us.
That's right.
Yes, we'll do.
Thanks, Dan.
Be well, Dan. Aloha.
Have a good one. From Molokai, Dan Amhoff.
Right.
You know, hello, Dan from Molokai.
Well, he's talking about Media Salon. We have William Gazecki.
William Gazecki. I really didn't know, but I had heard of his movies, actually. Vanishing of the Bees, which was probably one of the most original documentaries of the bee crisis that we're facing, and controversial, I'm sorry. But he won an award for this. I think it was Best Picture.
So what are we going to show? A little promo about the Media Salon.
We have two of his, we have two of his trailers today.
Okay.
Not going to lie, the little promo thing bored me, sorry. But the two trailers of two of his films that, I don't know if you'll talk about them, but definitely to get to know the guy at least. So let's go ahead and take a look at the Vanishing of the Bees trailer.
Let's look at this.
Came out in 2009 Best Picture Award.
I started out making films with both a technical and a creative production background. So I had experience in both the technical craft of sound mixing and the creative craft of record production and producing music and producing records. So I felt I had a pretty good handle on the creative process side and on some of the technology. Essentially, I began as an educational video maker, and I was making short educational films, and the economics of it were such that I really had to do all the jobs. I really couldn't afford to budget a production and complete it without doing everything. I had to write it, I had to shoot it, I had to edit it, and I had to deliver it, and also counsel with the client in terms of what they really wanted and realizing their vision, realizing their idea of what they wanted to get across. And when I went from producing educational videos into documentary films, I pretty much carried the same pro forma with me into the documentary genre. And
I think that for a lot of people, when they think about bees, they think about getting stung. Honeybees are essential. They are essential if you want fruits, if you want vegetables, because they pollinate all of those crops.
A lot of people out there don't realize that one out of every three bites of food they stick in their mouth, these honeybees put on their dinner table.
And without bees taking pollen from one apple tree to another apple tree, you wouldn't get any apples. And we estimate that the value of honeybees is nearly $16 billion in the United States alone.
Something is killing our honeybees in staggering numbers.
There's a name for what's happening, colony collapse disorder.
We're defining colony collapse as a condition where we see the rapid loss of the adult bee population.
Well, here's a beehive these bee scientists found a couple days ago. It was full of bees. 3 hours later, nobody home.
Something weird is going on here.
Normally, when a hive of bees is dead, first thing that happens, the other bees come in and rob it out. And with this new phenomenon, the boxes are full of honey, and 100 yards away sets another yard of bees that won't even look at this stuff.
Ooh, well, that one's gone.
My take on colony collapse is it is one of the signs, the really unmistakable signs, that our food system is unsustainable.
Bees are an indicator of environmental quality. When the bees are dying, something's wrong.
We put agencies like the EPA in place to moderate the avarice of corporations, and they have not done it. Instead, they've been corrupted.
We're in a war here, and we're going to lose a percentage of our troops consistently. We're going to keep fighting.
We don't have to wait for the government to act on some of these issues. We can do something today.
We are going to try to save them so they won't disappear.
We are starting a biodynamic farm, and in the heart of the farm is a honeybee sanctuary.
Save our bees! Save our agriculture!
Don't show this on camera. Okay. You can look at it right here. Matter of fact, just cut, you got the camera off? Turn it off.
So, bees, as
wow.
We know, every third bite you put in your mouth.
Every third bite, wow. So that's a major thing. So, he's done this one and he did another one on crop circles, huh?
Yeah,
and he's been a pretty prolific documentary producer.
He's a pretty prolific documentary
maker. So when is this, January 15th?
January 15th, he's going to be here.
Okay.
And I mean, another media salon like we did Linda Booger.
And
he's going to basically talk about how he makes his movies and how it comes about and films it. And it's kind of really interesting. I didn't know much about him, and, you know, I didn't really get involved, and then I started watching some of the trailers.
Just visiting here? He lives here?
I think he's visiting. I don't know. I don't really know the gist of how long or why or how, but somehow Akaku is going to bless our presence.
That's great. That's great.
Yeah.
We have another video clip from him?
Yeah.
Is that what's coming up? This one's on crop circles.
Yeah.
A couple
Let's
of minutes.
Let's take a look at this one.
We'll see you soon.
Look at this one, too.
Ooh.
These things are footprints of intelligences.
A mutual exploration of what is possible.
To understand the message is to assume there might be a message.
Plants were beautifully swirled around.
As you can see, it's a 90-degree bend.
What makes crop circles? It's an impossible question.
There were scientists. They were out there with all sorts of equipment. They had cameras, they had radar, they had other measuring devices.
We got a 25-minute gap where 140 circles appeared.
I think we're talking about other civilizations who are not based on Earth.
That seems to locate where there's water.
These shapes that we're seeing were actually shadows of a higher dimensional object.
And I saw this object come into view.
We have on film this ball of light.
Then it took off.
It might be supernatural, I don't know for sure.
And how did they get away with it? How are they not caught? How have they done it?
They don't practice, there's never a half-finished one, no mistakes.
It's just here, and it arrived in a few hours in perfect condition.
Wow, that got my attention.
So, conspiracy theorists galore. No.
Well, that isn't even conspiracy. That basically says there
these
is something greater than us.
These exist. That's great. Why do they exist? And where the heck do they come from?
Is that
from?
A short or is that a regular kind of a movie?
These are real full-length documentaries, and I just took the trailers.
Wow.
To show people kind of.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah. So you can see, though, that he does a wide range of documentaries. I will say that a lot of them are kind of conspiracy. You know, the Waco movie he did on the Texas massacre. I may be wrong, but it was about Waco. The catastrophe in Waco was an FBI cover-up. So I think his earlier movies were way more conspiracy theory or cover-up movies.
We'll see.
But he won all of his awards, not all of them, but a lot of awards were for Vanishing of the Bees. So whether that can be mainstream or, you know, whatever you consider, but that was a big movie for him. And but now he's working on a documentary of the life of one of those old Hollywood actresses. I forget her name, but
You spoke to him or stuff?
No, I looked it all up. You know.
No.
My little research, you know. But the Vodder of.
I feel a sneeze coming on. Oh boy.
A Vodder era.
See, it's nice and cool in here. William Gazecki. You know,
media classes.
We have a special announcement.
Media classes. This just in, folks. In our intro class, the next one's on the 20th.
Okay.
So if you want to get involved, you have to pick the intro class. No ifs, ands, buts around it. $20, folks. Come on in.
4 to 6 p.m. on Monday, January 20th.
Yes.
And then we have field production and camera on January, where am I?
It looks like the 11th this time.
January 11th, so yeah. It's hard to do that one before.
But field camera, I think, is 3 days. I could be wrong.
Okay.
3 days.
And then we have this Mojo mobile video.
Yeah,
the Y-beam kids, the kids going out.
No, I think this is for kids. I don't know.
No, but this is the same equipment they use. They have iPods.
Yes, it is.
Sitting on a
and you
mini
can add
pod.
It on these iPod touches too.
Fantastic.
And you put them on sticks and for study or shot.
So that's a thing coming up, and
looks
then
like the
studio
14th.
Production show in February.
Studio
February
production.
25th,
so if you need to get involved with this show,
February
you want 28th. To. You need to be studio certified. In order to be studio certified, you have to take studio production. So that would be the 25th through the 28th.
Okay. Well, we'll be talking about this again. You can check out our website on facebook.com mm-hmm. at Akaku.
Akaku.org. Right. Or Facebook, Akaku, Maui Community Television.
Right.
And we also have an editing class, the 25th.
So in February, if you check the schedule, you'll see.
So lots of classes coming
third
up.
Week,
Any one
fourth
of them
week
can get
of February.
You in here. Just pick one, sign up, do it, learn.
This is so much
fun.
You know, a lot of people are realizing that this is the core of a group that is going to be working, because
yes.
we're developing a TV industry here, and this is the core
Hopefully.
Of it.
That's the goal.
Great.
There has been a push to make a movie industry here for sure. So,
well,
hoping to slide in under the radar as like a live show.
Well, we are the radar. Yeah. There is nothing else around
True.
Here.
We are community.
We are the radar.
We are the radar.
Anyway, we have classes coming up in February and in late January. If you've already had the intro class, field and mobile production. It's amazing. You can actually do editing in the field and send it up all directly. That's fantastic. To get in touch, 871-5554 is Akaku, and see the front desk. Or again, if you have any questions about
Email
it, all you can always do.
Dana at akaku.org.
Anything,
everything.
She's the answer woman. She knows it
Let
all.
Me know. I think we're going to take a short PSA break. Now that we've run through the classes, we're going to look at what Akaku
okay.
does.
We're going to have a little PSA break. We'll see you in a minute.
Akaku is your community resource, offering advanced training in digital technology. You'll find online video and information at your fingertips. Developing new and innovative programming. Bringing you live events as they happen throughout Maui County. Akaku. Serving you for over 20 years.
Well, That's what we do here. Over 20 years.
You know, this has been 20 years. It's amazing.
See if we can get the webcam up. We have it up here. Let's see if we can get it up in there.
Yeah, we are happy to say we are not at minus 4, minus 3. We are in the plus digits for weather.
We're doing good. We're not negative 50 like Green Bay was.
It was cold and cooler last night, but... Nothing like I'm seeing.
I will tell
seeing.
You, it got down to 67 in Kihei.
No.
No.
67, that cold.
So. Oh, hyperthermia weather if you live in Hawaii.
People on the mainland wonder, what are we talking about?
Yeah, right.
Your blood does
they're
thin when you're here a long time.
They're running around in their bathing suits on vacation and we're panicking.
That's right. They're loving it. They're going, oh, shirt sleeve weather. It's...
Short sleeve.
That's right. It's in the 60s. We love it.
Hi,
we're freezing.
That AC? And we're dying.
Now look at this. We're looking at the gas station over here.
It looks like it's like
they have
a
new tanks
hurricane.
Coming in, but it does look like a lot of wind going on.
Looks like a bunch of wind.
That's
and,
the webcam.
Well, they're redoing the whole gas station.
Wow. Yeah.
They're putting good. In all new tanks, folks, so the EPA can't bitch.
Yeah, it's been many years, so that's a good thing.
Yeah, it has.
You know, we are so happy to have you joining us every day.
We are.
We're running credits, and that means we know the show is over.
Boo.
But
Jason, we just have way too much fun. Why do we have to end?
Way too much fun. We're happy you join us. If you'd like to be part of us, be in touch.
Be part of us.
Thank you for joining us.
Oh, here we have.
Aloha. We're still talking. They're wondering, hey, why are these guys ending the show?
It looks like a hurricane, though. I looked
it does
look
like a hurricane.
It was all overcast and windy, but this is just downright hurricane weather.
Well, I'm just thrilled that we're here and doing this.
We have real weather, I think that's what that means.
Bye.
Not just fake weather.
Bye.